Hello students, today we are going to start learning the first poem of your course My Mother at 66 by Kamala Das from Flamingo Book. Before I teach you the poem children, let me tell you something about the writer of this poem, Kamala Das. Kamala Surya, her name after her birth, Madhva Kutti, her name, her pen name, and Kamala Das, her name after her marriage. She took birth in the year 1934 and 31st March, and she died in 2009. Clear? She took birth in Kerala, but most of the part of her childhood had been spent in Calcutta, as her father was posted in Calcutta. She took up writing at a very early age, and she was married at the age of 15, and after her marriage, her husband inspired her, motivated her, or we can also say allowed her to write, because she was contributing to the family income. Throughout the day, she used to complete her household work, and at night she used to write when everybody would be asleep. Kamala Das is also known as a confessionalist poet. Why? Because through her poems and writings, she has confessed about her life, the truths of her life. She was given the title of the mother of Indian English poetry, and she had won several awards. She gained literary fame after her autobiography, My Story, got published. She was highly inspired by her uncle, Nalapath Narayan Menon, and her mother, Nalapath Balamani Amma. Clear? Now, Das's writings are characterized by the rebellion against the taboos that society imposes on a woman. Her writings are replete with the longings and desires that a woman has for self-impression and freedom. Her writings explore a huge gamut of human relationships from the woman's perspective as a mother, as a daughter, as a wife, as a person, and also as a non-conformist poet. Alright? The poem Mother at 66 is an explicit reflection of Kamala Das's sensitivity as a writer. She's actually very good at capturing the complications of human relationship, and she has done that very good, very nicely in this poem. And in this poem, she has also mentioned the pain and agony of her aged mother. This poem brings home the theme that aging is a natural phenomena, okay, is a natural process, and it will envelop every one of us. Clear? It is an inescapable phase of life, from childhood to, from infancy to childhood, from childhood to adolescence, and from adolescence to adulthood. We all have to grow, okay? We all are going to go ahead with this aging process, isn't it? Now, this poem has shown how the aging process is a natural process, alright? And it has also shown that how sometimes we, in order to fulfill our dreams, in order to chase and pursue our dreams, we forget that there are elderly people at home who need us, who need our love, who need us to be by their side when they need us, right? And this poem has also is also telling us that how sometimes we have to relinquish few commitments in order to fulfill others. All right? Sometimes a lady has responsibilities towards her husband, towards her family, and she has to relinquish the responsibilities towards her parents, isn't it? So this is the theme of the poem, children. Now I'm going to begin the poem. In this poem, Kamala Das had come to stay with her parents for a few days. Her visit at her parents' house has come to an end, and now she has to go back to her place. Clear? Now, when she has to go back to her place, for that, she has to board her flight from Cochin Airport. Clear? Where was Kamala Das? She was at her parents' home. Okay. When her visit at her parents' home came to an end, now she has to go back to her place. But for that, she has to board her flight from Cochin Airport. Clear? Now, from her parents' home to Cochin Airport, she was driving a car. She was in a car. She went to Cochin Airport from her parents' home by a car. Clear? And her mother accompanied her in the car. Her mother was sitting on the seat beside her and Kamala Das was driving. When Kamala Das was driving, she suddenly looked at her mother. Clear? When she looked at her mother's face, she compared her mother's face with a corpse. She found her mother's face lifeless, dull, pale, alright, colorless, and her mother's face looked like a dead body, a corpse. Clear? She could see that her mother is aging, has become aged. Clear? And she could see the pain and agony behind that colorless, dull, pale face. She realized that not only her mother, but she herself was also aging. Clear? As the title is telling us, my mother at 66, so it is telling us the aging process, that how we all, you know, acquire age so soon. We all, you know, grow, we all become aged so soon. Clear? So when Kamala Das looked at her mother, who was sitting on the side seat, right, she became very upset. Alright, she realized her mother could wither any moment and she became very upset. That thought upsets her, grieves her. Clear? And then she shifts her attention outside the window of the car. Clear? Just to, deviate her attention, just to take her attention away from that, she looked outside the window and she observed two things outside the window. One, she saw the sprinting trees. What do you mean by sprinting, children? Running. Okay, when we are in a car or any other vehicle and we go straight, then the trees actually seem running in the opposite direction. Clear? So, when she shifted her attention from her mother to the trees outside the car, she could see the trees and also the merry children spilling, the happy children coming out of their houses in knots and playing. They were very, very happy. So, there were two opposites at the two sides of Kamala Das. At one side was the death, clear, was a colorless, pale, dull, lifeless face. And on the other side was the energy, vigor, vitality, rejuvenation. Right, in the form of happy children and sprinting trees. Here, sprinting trees may also denote the aging process. Okay, because it doesn't stop and the trees were also passing very fast. Clear? So, the two sides of Kamala Das denoted two different things, two opposite things. One side, death, and one side, life, energy, happiness, rejuvenation, vigor, vitality. Alright, so these were the two opposites that she witnessed. After that, Kamala Das reached airport, clear, and after her security check was done, when she reached airport, first of all, she went ahead with her security check, and after it was done, she was standing at a distance from her mother. She was standing at a few yards distance from her mother, and when she looked at her mother, okay, she again made a comparison of her mother's face with a late winter moon. Here the second comparison has been done, children. The first one was done with a corpse, right? Now here the second comparison has been done and the second comparison is with the late winter moon. Why late winter moon? Because the late winter moon is foggy, misty and dull, pale. Clear? It is not as beautiful as a summer moon, Clear? It's very much foggy. So she compared her mother's face with the winter moon over here. Then she was somewhere having that guilt within that she cannot stay with her mother. She had suddenly, when she was looking at her mother, no, she had apprehensions that she may not meet her mother again. Okay, she had that apprehension that when she'll come back, she may or may not find her mother alive. Clear? And suddenly, the last few moments of togetherness ticks her. Clear? And she feels the same kind of fear as she used to feel in her childhood. What do you mean by childhood fear here, children? When we are children, we are always afraid of getting parted with our parents and especially mother. Clear? So here, that same kind of fear, the uncanny fear, gripped her mind. Okay, that upsets her. She became very sad. That fear, you know, hovered her. Clear? And she just, in order to be very optimistic or to keep the hopes alive, she said to her mother, "See you soon, Amma." But remember, she had apprehensions that she may or may not meet her mother again. Clear? But still, to be optimistic and keep her hopes alive, she said, "See you soon, Amma." Clear? And gave a smile. Alright? But that smile was a hollow smile. Clear? The anxiety and worries were hidden under that smile. She was really afraid. She was really in fear. She was in anxiety that whether I am going to meet my mother again or not. She was leaving her mother, right? She had to, you know, fulfill other commitments. And in order to fulfill other commitments, she had to relinquish the commitments with her mother. Clear? She had to leave her mother. She had to, you know, go away from her mother, though she knew that her mother needs her. So somewhere that guilt was within her that, yes, my mother needs me and I cannot stay with her. This poem, Mother at 66, is a poignant expression of fear of losing her mother. Clear? Of course, she had guilt within her that she cannot stay with her mother. Clear? She was unhappy. And her mind was continuously, in fear. She was scared that she may or may not meet her mother again. So this is what is there in the poem. Clear, children? Now we are going to read the poem. I'm going to explain you the poem, children. Mother at 66, written by Kamala Das. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday. Alright, so what did I tell you, children? That Kamala Das was at her parents' home, right? She was at her parents' house, and her visit to her parents' house has come to an end, and now she has to go to her own place. Clear? So what was the day, children? It was a Friday. And from where has she to board the flight? From Cochin Airport. Clear? So from her parents' house, she was going to Cochin Airport in a car. And I saw my mother beside me, who accompanied Kamala Das in car. Her mother. Clear? Her mother accompanied her to Cochin Airport. Her mother dozed open mouth. When her mother was sleeping, sitting beside her, she was dozing. Alright, she was sleeping. She was dozing. Her mouth was loosely open. Her mouth was slightly open. Clear? And her face ashen like that of a corpse. Here, ashen means dry. Alright, so her face was dry. Her face was dull, pale, colorless, lifeless, just like a corpse. What do you mean by corpse, children? A dead body. So she has made the first comparison over here. The mother's face is compared to the corpse. Alright? And realized with pain that she was as old as she looked. Of course, she realized that her mother was getting old. All right, the title, Mother at 66. The aged mother, the pain of her aged mother, that pain she could witness on her face. The decaying of the physical body, all right? Her mother's body was decaying, all right? And it could wither any moment. So what has been explained here? That her mother's face has been compared to a dead body and she looked as old as her age was. Her physical body was getting decayed. Now, but soon put that thought away. Of course, she tried to shift her attention from there and looked out of the at the young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling. Now, at one side was death. She tried to shift her attention outside the window, and outside the window, she could see two things, as I told you. The young trees sprinting means running. But here I told you, why the trees seem sprinting or running? Because when we are in vehicle, whenever we are in a vehicle or a car or in any other vehicle, then the trees seem running in the opposite direction. Clear? So here also the trees were sprinting and the children in groups came out, all right, in knots came out of their houses and they were so happy. Clear? So there were two opposite things two sides of Kamala Das. So they came out of their homes, children came out of their homes, but after the airport security check, now here Kamala Das and her mother had reached airport and Kamala Das went ahead with security check. Standing a few yards away, she was standing at a few yards distance from her mother, looked again at her van. Van means colorless. Alright, this word means colorless, right? So, colorless, pale as a late winter's moon. Now, here the second comparison has been done. First one was with the corpse and second one is with the winter's moon. Why? Because winter's moon is foggy, misty, not clear, all right, and felt that old familiar ache. Ache means pain. Clear? A very familiar pain she felt of her childhood's fear. The way she was afraid in her childhood of getting parted from her mother. In the beginning of the lesson, I told you that she was highly inspired by her mother's writing. So she must be very much connected with her mother, right? And when she is getting parted from her mother, then she actually she felt that pain the way she used to feel in her childhood. Clear? Now, but all I said was, see you soon, Amma, just to be optimistic, right? Just to, you know, keep her hopes alive or to hide her guilt that she is not at the side of her mother when her mother needs her. So, but all she said was, see you soon, Amma. And all I did was smile, smile and smile. But it was a hollow smile to hide her anxieties and worries, to hide her pain, to hide her fear that she is getting parted from her mother and she may or may not meet her mother again. So this is the poem, children. Now let me tell you the literary devices that have been used in the poem. First of all, this poem is a free verse. What do you mean by free verse, children? When you do not have a set rhyming scheme in a poem, it is known as a free verse. I hope you know what rhyming scheme is. Now when you do not have any rhyming scheme in the poem, children, it is a free verse. So this poem is not having any set rhyme scheme. So first thing that I told you is free verse. Alright, now second is, this poem is written in a single line. This entire poem is a single line punctuated with commas. Right, though the commas have been used, but this poem is a single line. Okay. Now, the next thing is similes. There are two similes used in the poem, children. One is, what is simile? Simile is when we compare two different things using like and as. Alright? For example, she is like a fairy. Now, I have compared a girl with a fairy and I have used the word like. right? So here her mother's face has been compared to cops using like. Alright, so it is a simile. Alright, so simile has been used here. Another simile has been used here again when her mother's face has been compared to winter's moon using as. So simile is when we compare two things using like or as. So here as has been used to compare her mother's face. Alright children, now the third literary term that had been used is repetition. Right, when same word, phrase or line is repeated in a poem, it is known as repetition. So here the word smile had been used thrice. Alright, so what literary term it is children? It is repetition. So three things I have already told you: free verse, simile and repetition. Fourth is symbolism. Alright, symbolism is when few things are used in a poem as a symbol of some other thing, like trees sprinting and the merry children spinning. Here are the symbol of vigor, vitality, rejuvenation, energy, young age. So here they are the symbols. So what literary term has been used children? Symbolism. And the last one is imagery. Now what is imagery? When a certain image is formed through words by a writer to describe a certain phenomena, right? Now here the image of trees sprinting, as soon as we say trees sprinting, we start imagining that how the trees would sprint and the merry children spilling. Now the merry children were just coming out in knots, in groups, right? And we can imagine how children happily must be coming out of their houses. So two images have been created through these two phrases, right? So here imagery has been used. So this is all that has been used here. These are the poetic devices that have been used here children. Free verse, because there is no rhyming scheme in this poem. Second is simile, two similes, the comparisons using like and as. Repetition, the repetition of smile, smile and smile. Then we have symbolism, okay, and then we have the imagery. Clear? These are the five literary devices, and remember this poem is written in a single line using punctuations. Clear? Now I hope you have understood the poem children. Let us quickly revise the poem children. The poem is Mother at 66 and has been written by Kamala Das. About Kamala Das, I have already told you at the beginning of the lecture, right? Now, what was there in the poem children? In the poem, we saw that author was going, right? Who is the author? Kamala Das. From where was Kamala Das going? From her parents' home, okay? Where was she going? She was going to Kochi airport. When she was going, it was Friday morning, as has been mentioned. And how was she going? She was going by car. So this was the beginning of the poem, that Kamala Das has come to an end of her visit to her parents' home, and now she was going to her own place, and she is going to board a flight from Cochin airport. And hence, to go to Cochin airport, she was driving and her mother accompanied her. So this was the beginning of the poem children. And when she looked at her mother, alright, when she looks at her mother, okay, in the car, then she compared her mother to the corpse, alright, the dead body, clear, the lifeless face, the deathly face, alright, and she also compared her mother to winter, late winter moon, alright, late winter moon she compared when they reached airport, but these were the two comparisons that were done, that was pale, dull, lifeless, bit like a winter moon, like a dead body, her mother was being compared to, right? Then she shifted her attention, and then when she shifted her attention and she looked outside the car, she saw the young trees sprinting and the merry children playing. Now the young trees sprinting was, and the merry children playing tell us something opposite to what was there in the car. In the car was her mother, which was ashen, dry, dull, pale, dead body, like a dead body, like a winter moon. And here, children are the symbol of energy, vigor, vitality, young age, rejuvenation. All right, so there is a comparison between the two opposites are the two sides of Kamala Das, right? Now coming here, children, poet's feeling after looking at her mother dozing off with her half open mouth. These two actually were the feelings at the airport. All right, mother at the airport. Poet's feeling after looking at her mother at the airport. She had that childhood fear of losing her and the familiar ache of childhood. In childhood, we usually are afraid of losing our parents, right? So the same fear the poet felt when she was at airport. She felt as if she's losing her mother, as if she's going away from her mother and she would never see her mother again. So these were the things. How did she depart, children? She departed very optimist when she departed from there, because the optimism is very much clear when she said, "See you soon, Amma," right? And second, she gave a hollow smile. Why am I calling it a hollow smile again and again? Because behind that smile, under that smile, Kamala Das was trying to hide the pain that she was having that time, the ache that she could actually feel that time of getting separated from her mother, because her mother was aging and she knew, she actually thought that I might not see my mother again. Alright, so this was a quick revision of the poem through a mind map, right? And next, at last, I would really like to remind you the theme of the poem, children. The first theme is aging is a phenomena, right? An unescapable phase of life. We all have to go through it, alright? The physical decay with the passage of time is very much sure, right? Assured. And we need to go from infancy to childhood, childhood to adolescence, adolescence to adulthood. And we'll have to go through it, right? We cannot stop it. Aging will definitely envelop every one of us, alright? So we will have to go through it. Second is, life has its own toll over human relationships. In order to fulfill one commitment, we have to relinquish others. Alright, so this is the theme of the poem. We have to, sometimes take tough calls when we leave our parents and go away from them in order to pursue our dreams, career, in order to fulfill our dreams, we have to go away from our parents. But we should keep in mind that parents need love, attention, alright? So we should be at their side when they need us. Alright? So this is what is there in the poem, children. I hope you have understood it. Thank you.